Yes, what's up Melbourne? What's up Australia? What's up the world? Right now going down here, we have exhibition match between Anecdote and 360. Make some noise! Yeah! We're going 4 rounds, no judges, just for the fans. 60, you want heads or tails?
Tails.
Never fails. But on this occasion it does. Anecdote, you go first. 60, 1 minute rounds, let's set it off. 60 first.
Hey, yo. Alright. Anecdote. You a faggot, bro. You're about to get beat down like Cameron Cloak. And then when me and you got to the States, I wanted to say peace out and travel home. Cause he kept freaking out in the middle of the night screaming, Daddy, don't!
That's true.
One day he said, yo, just because I get raped by my dad and I take it knuckle deep, does that make me a fag? Dude, it doesn't matter who you are. Cause I know how much of a faggot you are when we hit up a strip club and this cunt sat in the car. And I don't like you as a person. Man, I only like the fact you hooked us up to stay at Lewis Logic's crib a while back. You must have been overwhelmed staying at your idol's pad, because you forgot to take the opportunity to give me style back. But me and you work together, yo. Never call it a friendship, because you're the last person I'd ever want to be friends with. But in America, you had the best time too, true. That's because more faggots there like to dress like you do. You a puss, mate. Say something. I'll climb your family tree and start face-fucking your late cousin.
Yeah, keep talking shit. I'ma split your lips with uppercuts. I think this bitch is just the dumbest cunt. Cause when I found out he agreed to this battle, I thought all my Christmases had come at once. Yeah, cause it don't take a genius to tell the shit he's spitting fucking sucks. I go hard, but beating him is child's play like little kids with rubber ducks. And in this town, there ain't nobody hopeless as 60. So all these people had me flown in from Sydney to get rid of the biggest joke in their city. Shit. You're getting tough like he's going to hit me. But you're too bony and skinny because you smoke cones like a chimney and snort coke like you're Whitney. So you get served like waiters. And I earn my paper, but he's still saving his pennies for his first vibrator. He's got an identity crisis. Started out as a surf lifesaver. Now we can't choose. Should I be a curbside skater or a dirt bike racer? Hey, yo, so fuck this. I'll use your face to paint the canvas. Let's give him some career advice. You should change your name to Candace and form a group of table dancers.
Time!
No disrespect, but you kind of remind me of that thesaurus cat. You can hold your own in a battle but sound like a fuckhead on recorded tracks. Thinking pressing a CD might just get in respect now? Dude, that shit wasn't a CD, that shit was a letdown. And I'd love to know how many copies of his CD sold when I sold 1,500 when it was 3 weeks old. And when we play in Sydney, he doesn't get to see me roll because he's backstage keeping my fucking VBs cold. Yo, no fucking lie, his real name is actually Conrad Ball. Your mum's a dumb bitch, why the fuck did she call you Conrad for? The only time you hear Conrad ever drop a bomb track is when he drops the emo shit and he starts growing a cock back. Your mum's depressed as fuck. She tried to have fun, but it didn't work. The only time that bitch has ever had a ball was giving birth. And you will not finish first, and this can be a cartoon, and you'd be Marge Simpson's person, I'd be fucking Mr. Burns. Bitch. Look at his fucking head. Look at it.
Yeah. My birth name is Conrad Ball, and he's not that tall. Skinny bitch, when he was in primary school, his parents wouldn't let him play contact sports. Yeah. Let's go back to 2007. He found out that battling's hard. Spat some embarrassing bars. Thank you. And thank God I was there to carry his ass. Yeah. I bet this faggot would march in gay parades in panties and bras. Your whole career's a joke, but no one actually laughed. Yeah. And when we went to New York, he had a wet dream on the plane deck. Woke up with his cock in his hand, screaming the name Pez. Yeah. We got to the hotel, didn't even have the keys to the place yet, when he whispered in my ear, hey dude, can we sleep in the same bed? Yeah. And I have no idea how he's gonna pay rent when he performs blowjobs but takes semen as paychecks. He says he's cleaner than safe sex, wrapped his penis in latex, but how the fuck did he end up with a D on his AIDS test? No. And if you wanna know how this guy makes a living, he's a mud wrestler who fights naked women.
Time!
In the lightweight division.
Yeah. 360, go.
Yeah. Dude, That albino shit proved that you deserve to die. Cause I might be the surfing type, but now his whole career's based on being burnt alive. And I admit I've dropped some tracks that are kinda corny, but I fucked the shit out of a scene that is slightly boring. But what I should have done is sold my soul to write a story and get a faggot-like lyrics born to just step in and write it for me. Oh. Melbourne hip hop's Alfred Hitchcock's back. Albino and Anecdote. I wish both them faggots did not rap. Next this faggot will probably be doing a lip gloss ad. No one wants to hear a hip hop track about a weird-headed motherfucker campaigning for slip, slop, slap. You're starting to build a rep for that pale white dome. Dick Smith should stand him out the front and just get him to sell light clothes. But what's next for the albino? They'll probably dress him as a rapping apple and get him to sell iPhones. Yo, I don't know what I think of your image. Dude, it's a pretty poor gimmick that is mixed with more gimmicks. You didn't write the albino shit, man. Lyrics Born did it. What kind of faggot wants to go and spit some Lyrics Born lyrics?
Time! Anecdote!
Yeah, I will take your mic. Don't get me wrong, I don't hate Forthright. But how the fuck do two guys get AIDS four times? They're two faggots. They want to lay more pipe. They take it in turns, pitching and catching and call it baseball night. You can see them making out at basketball games courtside. Then they get romantic and hold hands on their skateboard rides. Work up a sweat, go home and get changed all right. Then videotape sword fights to upload on their favorite gay porn sites. You've got a gay disease, you fag. And I admit, that albino shit was a lame and cheesy act, but fuck it, they paid me heaps of cash. And since you're always copying me and everything you say is completely whack, next summer he may release a track called Stay Between the Flags. I think you're overstepping the mark. He snorts lines of coke, gets adrenaline charged and wants to fight, till he remembers he can't. You've got no job! You can't rap, and you live in your parents' garage. It's safe to say his adult life is off to a terrible start.
Time! 3 seconds.
Yeah. Alright. Yo, you the type of guy to wrestle with your mates sometimes, true? Well, Comrade Ball, I fucking hate cunts like you. You need to dismount my dick now. Before I beat this weird-headed bitch down like Chris Brown. And I'm firing more shots than a sawn-off. And you're an asswipe, but the last time his jaw dropped, the floor got a sore spot. But why the fuck are you here? Leave. He's such a pussy, even on New Year's Eve, his mates were like, come on, comrade, let's just have a few beers, please. His mum's fat as fuck. Since birth, she only ate burgers. She's an overweight version of an overweight person. And each one of her titties look like beanbags, dude. I'd give that bitch respect, but she'd probably eat that too. Well, you are Sydney's own kidney stone. He couldn't kiss a hoe if he got a bunch of mistletoe and got rehypnol and got the bitch alone and spiked her fucking drink. Look at his face again. Look at that shit. That's it.
Time! Anecdote!
Hey, yo, they look baggy on you, but for anyone else, they'd be extra tight pants. So you need to get off the exercise plan and stop purchasing extra light ham. Hey, yo, I hit you to death with right hands and end your lifespan. The only time you find him next to mic stands is as Pez's hype man. Okay, and dude, this motherfucker, he can't take it off of the dome. See, he fucked up his freestyles and tried to play it off as a joke. Hey, yo. And I already said you fight women in our lightweight division. He fucks up his freestyles after using his ninth page of writtens, but seeing him trying to come off the dome is like watching a highway collision. So you better stop the rap. Stop the crap before I knock you flat like a fucking skinny bean boxing bag. My mum's not skinny, that was a joke for sure. And if like there was a boat I saw, I'm freestyling, I'd still throw you overboard. And this, you shouldn't flow. I got some raps that you shouldn't quote. I'd throw you in the water, but you're so full of shit you wouldn't float.
Time! That's the end of this exhibition match. Shake hands, Alex.